In LabVIEW, a VI is a virtual instrument, and it consists of two parts, a front panel and a block diagram. The front panel is the collection of controls like knobs or switches or buttons that are the controls or the inputs into your code. It also contains graphs or other types of meters or lights that are the indicators or outputs. To create these, you use functions that come off of a palette. This is a pop-up window that allows you to drag and drop the functions onto the front panel. Behind every front panel, the controls and the indicators, is the block diagram. And the block diagram is the code that actually runs all of these functions. The code is graphical programming code, so it consists of a variety of functions and other types of structures connected together by wires. These as well come off of its own palette, which has a collection of the different functions, sometimes called sub-VIs, that can be dragged and dropped onto the block diagram to create the functionality behind the front panel. Here we'll show very quickly the process of creating a VI in LabVIEW, specifically demonstrating the front panel and block diagram capabilities. This is meant to just quickly demonstrate the range of possibilities of the types of things that you can create using the front panel. Here I've added a knob, which allows the input of a variety of different values. Here's an OK button. And finally, a third control I'll add is a stop button. In terms of outputs, there's many different types of indicators. I'm going to add a meter here, which displays a value. As each was added on the block diagram, I can then start to wire these together, creating the code and the functionality of how my program will actually execute. I'm doing this very quickly, but the idea of this program that I'm writing is to first control the speed of a motor and then to read the ambient value of a light sensor. Once I have created all of this and wired it together, I then can take my robot, which I have a motor connected as well as the ambient light sensor, and run my program. At first, nothing is happening because my knob is set to zero, but as I increase that value, you can see the motor turning according to that speed. When I click the OK button, it starts reading the ambient light sensor and displaying that value on the meter. So as it becomes darker, the value goes down. As it becomes lighter, the value goes up. And finally, I can hit the stop button to stop my program.